Next is paragraph type question, which says that let the curve y equal to fx passes through 4 comma minus 2 and satisfies the differential equation y into x plus y cube dx is equal to x y cube minus x into dy. And another curve is y equal to gx, that is integral from 1 by 8 to sine square x sine inverse root t dt plus integral 1 by 8 cos square x cos inverse root t dt from 0 to pi by 2. So we have to answer the following questions. Now let's firstly talk about the curve fx. So it has been given that xy dx plus y raised to the power 4 dx is equal to xy cube dy minus x square dy. So we can say xy dx plus x square dy is equal to xy cube dy minus y raised to the power 4 dx. Now if we divide by x square y cube on both sides, so here x will get cancelled and here we will get x square. So this is differentiation of xy divided by x square y square, which can be integrated very easily. And on the right hand side we have y by x into x dy minus y dx divided by x square. So that is differentiation of y by x into y by x, right? So integrating we get minus 1 by xy equal to y by x whole square divided by 2 plus constant. And it has been given that it is passing through 4 comma minus 2. So we have minus 1 divided by minus 8 equal to 1 by 8 plus constant, which means that value of constant is 0. So we are left with minus 1 by xy equal to y square upon 2x square. That is y cube is equal to minus 2x. That is y is equal to minus 2x raised to the power 1 by 3. So from the given options, we can see that it is passing through minus 4 comma 2. And it is also passing through minus 32 comma 4. So answer will be A and C option. Next, we are talking about the curve y equal to gx. So if we differentiate this function, then we will get g dash x equal to, putting t equal to sine square x, we will get sine inverse sine x into differentiation of sine square x, that is 2 into sine x into cos x, plus cos inverse of cos x into differentiation of cos square x, that is 2 into cos x into minus sine x. So this is equal to 2 cos x sine x taking common. Next we have sine inverse sine x minus cos inverse cos x. But here it has been given that x is going from 0 to pi by 2, where the value of this is also x and this is also x. So g dash x is definitely equal to 0, which means that gx is equal to constant. Now to find the value of that constant, now put x equal to pi by 4. So we will get gx equal to integral from 1 by 8 up till 1 by 2 sine inverse theta plus cos inverse theta, that is pi by 2 into dt. So this will give me pi by 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 8, that is 3 pi by 16. Right? So the curve is y equal to 3 pi by 16. So it is definitely passing through the point C comma T. Now in this question we have to find the area bounded by y equal to fx, y equal to gx, x equal to pi by 2 and y axis. So let's plot its graph. Graph of y equal to fx, that will be something like this. And y equal to gx, that is y equal to 3 pi by 16. And x equal to pi by 2, this is x equal to pi by 2, and y axis. So the area is this one, right? So area will be equal to 3 pi by 16 minus 2x raised to the power 1 by 3, and the integral will go from 0 to pi by 2 into dx. So that is equal to 3 pi by 16 into pi by 2 minus. Now its integral will be minus 2x raised to the power 4 by 3 divided by 4 by 3 minus 2. So the limit is from 0 to pi by 2. That is equal to 3 pi square by 32 minus, let's say this is plus, 3 by 8 taking outside. Here we will have pi raised to the power 4 by 3. So we can write it equal to 3 into pi raised to the power 4 by 3 upon 8 taking common, 1 plus pi raised to the power 2 by 3 divided by 4, right? So comparing it with the given value, we can say a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 4. So correct answer will be option number a, b, c, that's it. So answer is a, b and c. Now next, again we have a paragraph where this integral is given to be equal to 2 into secant alpha into under root of f theta minus 2 times cosecant alpha into under root of g theta plus constant, where alpha is an arbitrary constant. So the possible values of f of alpha is, right? So let us find this value of the integral. Sine 3 by 2 theta into d theta divided by under root of sine cube theta cos cube theta into sine theta plus alpha. Similarly, next we have cos 3 by 2 theta d theta divided by under root of sine cube theta cos cube theta into sine of theta plus alpha. Firstly, it can be seen that these values will get cancelled. So this is equal to integral d theta divided by cos square theta taking common, because in the under root we have sine of a plus b, that is sine a cos b plus cos a sine b, right? So taking cos theta common, we are left with tan theta cos alpha plus sine alpha. And second integral is d theta divided by taking sine square theta common. In the integral, we will be left with cos alpha plus cot theta into sine alpha. Further, to solve this, let us assume tan theta cos alpha plus sine alpha equal to t square. And here let's take cos alpha plus cot theta sine alpha equal to m square. So its differentiation will be cos alpha is constant, secant square theta d theta is equal to 2t dt, and here we will have sine alpha is constant minus cosecant square theta d theta is equal to 2m dm. So let's substitute it here. We will get integration of 2t dt divided by cos alpha into t, right? So these two will get cancelled, plus integral of cosecant square theta into d theta is 2m dm divided by minus sine alpha into m, right? So that is equal to 2 into secant alpha into t minus cosecant alpha into 2 into m. So comparing it with the given equation, we can see f of theta is equal to tan theta cos alpha plus sine alpha. Similarly, g theta is equal to m square, that is cos alpha plus cot theta into sine alpha. Now in question 54, it is talking about the possible values of f of alpha. Putting theta equal to alpha, we will get f of alpha equal to sine alpha plus sine alpha, that is 2 times sine alpha, right? So we have to talk about its possible values, but we have to take care that f of alpha here is in the under root. So f of alpha should definitely be greater than equal to 0, right? Also, Here, in the given integral, we can see that sine theta and cos theta are in the denominator. So, sine theta and cos theta both cannot be equal to 0. That is, it cannot take the values 0, pi by 2, pi and so on. Right? So, it can take the values 1, root 2 and root 3 but not 2. Next, it is talking about the possible values of f of alpha plus g of alpha. Now, here, g of alpha is equal to 2 times cos alpha. So, we can say that f of alpha plus g of alpha is equal to 2 times cos alpha plus sin alpha. Now, it can take the values from 2 up till 2 root 2. Right? So, the possible answers will be C and D option.